Media Current, and I'm just going to talk a little bit today about some different theming options. I know theming is an issue, especially people that are new to Drupal. It's kind of a steep learning curve, and some of the new technology that has come out recently, kind of competing technologies, some of them work together, some of them don't. Different tools to accomplish the task that is one of the more difficult things in Drupal, which is figuring out the theme layer and really getting your site to look unique, how you want it to look, how it looked in the design mockups before Drupal was involved. That's me. I've been working with Drupal since about 2007. A little bit with Joomla before that, and once I kind of figured out CCK and Vue's aspect of Drupal, I kind of never looked back. So that's where I'm coming from. All right. Basis of theming, kind of the building blocks of Drupal. Anyone who's familiar with Drupal or attended a CCK session today knows that. What most people do when they architect a site is they build a content type. So they take a node, they create a custom node type, and then they put the CCK fields on it that they're going to need based on what they have in their wireframes, and they're going to make it look like they want via the theming layer. Here's an example of, this is just my personal blog site. I've got the event node type. You can see we've got a sidebar over there set with various blocks. And we've got different CCK fields. The logo, the Drupal Camp logo, is a CCK image field. I've got a date CCK field. I've got a link. You'll see the Drupal Camp Atlanta, the blue HTML link there that goes back to the Drupal Camp website. That's a CCK field, node body, and then an embedded location view, which is a node reference field. So the question is, in Drupal, how do we get the site or this content type to look like this so that each time a content editor adds an event, all these pieces will be in the right places every time. So Drupal Core gives us, in the node displays UI, and let me know if I'm assuming maybe a little too much as far as the experience and building out. Feel free to ask questions while I'm going, before I go too far. But this is basically what you're looking at, what CCK gives you as far as what build modes do I want? Do I want the title to display? Do I not want the title to display? So you see it's fairly limited. And most of the time, this was done in Drupal by theming, printing different variables out, node content, et cetera. And we had great tools for this. The Devel Themer module, if no one's used it, is a wonderful tool that you can grab. In this example, I grabbed the image field of the peach there. It tells us what function was called, and it gives you the different variables, so you can figure out how to put those in your tpl.php file. Here's the problem that I ran into when I was first learning Drupal. Okay, how am I going to print this thing? What's the syntax? So what do? We go to Google, we look for somebody who's figured it out, we take the code snippet, we put it in our node content type, you know, .tpl.php. Well, what happens now if I have three or four images? I have unlimited images for that CCK field. How am I going to print? Okay, the first image in a big image with a light box, the other ones are going to be smaller images. Now I've got to cycle through arrays, et cetera. How am I going to do all that? Well, theming was difficult, and it still is difficult. It's also time consuming, even if you know how to do it. Lately, in the last couple of years, some different tools have come out. Display Suite is newer than Panels. Panels has gone through several iterations, including, I believe it was a Drupal 5 version. But Panels 3 now is what's out for Drupal 6, and they're currently working on porting that to Drupal 7. And so, in the theme layer, we talked about the tpl.php files. This is what we have. You know, every time you have a view that's added, every time you have a different node type, even though you might be doing the exact same thing, you got to create a tpl.php file. This requires server access. Maybe once you've handed a project over to a client now, you know, are you going to maintain access to their server to change this stuff? Are they going to be able to change it? So it's difficult. It's painful. All right, so here is the event node type from my blog that I created in Display Suite. Once again, it's exactly the same as what you saw labeled before. I'm just going to kind of show you how we arranged it and what Display Suite offers. So instead of just the normal display fields set that we have that Core Drupal gives us, Display Suite overrides that and allows you, as you can see here, all of the different node types I have for this Drupal site. And you can click which ones you want Display Suite to take control of. What it does, if you click it, And I believe this, yeah, this is, you're actually clicking what you want to exclude, so it's kind of counterintuitive, but I'm telling Display Suite right now, I want you to intercept at the theme layer and take control of all of my content types. All right, and here's what you get these different regions. So instead of just having the fields and whether you want the title, et cetera, and where do you want the title above, below, in line, you get a left region, a middle region, a header region, and a footer region. You can also disable fields completely. You know, I don't want to read more link, I don't want the post date, et cetera. I don't want the links that are in the links variable. You can then drag these fields, these fields into these regions that you want, and get pretty close to how most of the sites are going to look. Obviously, CSS comes into play here. You can style it. There are a lot of plugins for Display Suite, more and more are coming out every day. For example, go ahead, please.
Quick question: are these regions created in your theme, or are they created by Display Suite?
Okay. The question is: are these regions basically overridable in the created Display Suite? This is one of the disadvantages of Display Suite. These are the regions that you get, and you can't override them. We'll talk about a little bit later with panels how you can get around that. This is the Display Suite. The question was this an installed module? It's actually a suite of modules, Display Suite. This is the Node Displays module, which is part of Display Suite API. And I'm going to focus on just the Node Displays and Muse Displays, and then on panels, I'm just going to talk about nodes because there's just too much information, and they're too powerful to cover in an hour what all it can do. But essentially, it can override nodes, node edit, user profiles, pretty much any themeable element in Drupal. Okay, here's Views Display. The first time I figured out what this did, I think I actually might have cried a little bit. Basically, it's a Views plugin for style, and you get the same regions for your view. And that's how I set up the bubble in my GMAP display, which is pretty cool. I thought that I didn't have to do really any theming at all for that. All right, so here is the same exact content type that I laid out in panels now. I didn't style it because the live site is set up in Display Suite, but I just wanted to show very quickly kind of the differences, but I can do the exact same thing. You'll also notice that the bubble there, Georgia Tech Research Institute, that is still using the Views Display. So I'm using the Views Display style, and I'm embedding it into a panel, so they can be used together. And then the sidebar is being set with the context module. So I'm never going to claim that any of this is best practices. So it's just the way that I do things. All right, so here's how it looks in panels. Instead of seeing the regions kind of linear, you get kind of a visual element with some cool JavaScript as to the different regions, and these are configurable. You can create your own, you can use the standard ones, and actually it comes with a flexible one that you can actually drag around with your mouse and create the regions. It's not the cleanest markup to do that, and the creator of panels is the first to admit that it's not the cleanest markup when you do that, but if you create custom regions, you can make it pretty much exactly how you want it. All right, some things are going to be very easy to do in panels and are going to be very difficult to do in Display Suite. So panels is more powerful, but generally has a steeper learning curve. So this is just another content type that I wanted to show was using panels and kind of why. You see the two lower blocks there, the one that says RICD, it's a testimonial, and then the three pictures at the bottom, which are representing products in this mock-up. Those are node queues, which are views, so that a site owner can add, say he had featured products one week and he wanted to toggle those on and off. You know, so that's something I might allow a content editor to do, but I don't want access to the back end. So what panels allows us to do is he can go in there and create those things, you know, create the content, the new product, as it were, the slide, for example. Say I want this to be a featured product, and he can do that for all his featured products for all the different product types. And then whenever this page is viewed and controlled by panels, they're going to show up there. And the reason for that is arguments and the way that panels allows you to pass arguments to the view. You can do some of it in Display Suite through the default argument, but panels, and I'll show you guys a little bit later, pretty much any argument available, you can pass right through. Okay, here's how it looks at if you're controlling all of your content types in panels. So before you guys, I showed you the exclude matrix for Display Suite. anything not checked was being controlled by Display Suite. This is what Panels is doing. So I have three content types here, a how-to, a product line, and an element. They're all types of the node, so any node system. If any of these content types are being viewed, Panels is saying, I'm going to step in, I'm going to intercept the theme layer, and I'm going to take over the layout of that content type. The really cool thing about Panels, though, is if you have a CCK allows you to take a content type and create a template file for it. So for example, say you just had a title or a link or something, you want it to be like an H3 tag or something like that, you can still put that template file in your theme and Panels will respect it, which is very cool. All right, here's what it looks like. These are the same labels from before. You can see there's regions that aren't being used. And this was one of the flexible regions that I created. Like I said, the markup's not real clean, but it's extremely powerful, and you can go through multiple iterations very easily through the GUI, which is really helpful in the planning phase as well. Another advantage that I use Panels quite a bit for are landing pages. Display Suite is more for node types, views, et cetera, whereas Panels, you can create complete landing pages, setting a path. You guys have all seen the DrupalCamp website. It's got five views for each level of sponsorship in here, and it was just as easy as me dragging the view and dropping it into that UI to get those five views on that page. If you were to do that theming, you can do it. It just takes more time, and then you got to maintain the template file as well. Home pages, there's just a toggle in Panels that says, do you want me to take over the home page? That's what we did here. This is also Panels. Another cool thing about Panels, reusable styles and getting into reusability and maintainability. Unfortunately, Sheena from Top Notch Themes wasn't able to make it today. She does a great session on this and the use of the Skinner module to reuse styles over and over again so that every time you create a new block, you're not having to say, okay, I want this block to look like that, but I got to go in and grab the block ID and CSS, copy the CSS, and now I got to add that to my style sheet. Your style sheet gets really long. It's got to be loaded every time each page is loaded, depending on how you have your caching set up, et cetera. It's a performance drain and it's hard to maintain. Well, Panels not only allows you to take a system block that's styled with Skinner and embed it, you can actually apply that Skinner style to the panel region. So let me just back up if that's confusing, because I know it kind of sounds like it. So you could actually have these regions here. So not just this would have the Skinner style, but this whole entire area would have the Skinner style. And then outside of Skinner, you can also define, Skinner right now is limited to CSS only. It doesn't control the markup. So a lot of styles, you're going to need to control the markup as well. And Panels allows you, through plugin styles, to create template files for reusability for some reason. There we go. All right. The drop shadow one selected there is the top image there. See how that's a drop shadow style that requires markup? So it required some nested divs in order to create that effect. Panels allows you to do that with a plugin style. All right. Skinner, talking about, this is a good example, .view, node Q1. Well, what if I created three or four more views that I wanted the same style applied to? If I can't find a general common selector that I can use, or maybe I don't want to use it for all of those styles, I had to copy this and paste it each time. Style sheets got out of control. Reusability kind of helps out with that. Here's some references. I'll just kind of leave this up as I take questions, and then I'll start doing kind of a demo to show you more. This was more of an overview. I'm going to kind of show you some of the UI aspects of the two different things and how I achieve the same result with the two different modules. The two bit.ly links there, second from the bottom, are video podcasts from Mustard Seed Media. I don't know if any of you guys are familiar with those guys. They did he did a two-part Display Suite podcast, about 10 minutes each, and really did a really nice job of going through. That's, if you want to learn more about Display Suite, watch those two podcasts. That's really helpful. There's lots of write-ups on Panels, and we're currently working on the documentation for that. It's kind of, I'm sorry.
Are you going to have this available?
Yes, I will put the slides up, and we'll get that out. I can either put it up on slideshare.net, or I'll talk with the media current and see where they want it, but they will be available. All right. That is it for the slides. I was going to open it up for questions, and I know that there's going to be some on kind of just how do you enable panels? How do you enable display suite, et cetera, and kind of how it all works? While I get this set up, are there any questions? Nope. All right, so basically, display suite, normally on a content type, we'll take our event content type, and we'd go to display fields, and this is where we'd have our CCK controlled options. Right here, we're being told it's overridden by display suite. So we know that in that matrix, we didn't exclude it. Display suite's controlling it. So now I know I go to site building and display suite, node displays. Build modes will tell you which build mode. This is really kind of a cool feature that I didn't really talk too much about. But you can actually say, OK, I want display suite to do the full mode or the teaser or just the teaser. For example, my panels example, the teaser was being controlled by display suite, but the actual full mode was being controlled by panels. And I haven't done any like kind of serious benchmarks or anything, but I have not seen any real performance hits to using these modules even together. All right, let me just back up and show you what the different layouts. How do I get to these different things? So I know the event is being controlled by Display Suite. So here are my different different elements. You can also create your own build modes. What the slide didn't allow us to do is let's see here. Which ones have the formatters here? All right, fields. This is a really kind of a powerful kind of forward-thinking thing that the display suite developers did was that they realized that they were never going to be able to apply a plugin or have a plugin for every possible use case, every possible module, every possible CCK field out there. So you can add your own fields. For example, real cool feature, add a new code field. Anything that you would put in a theming template, you can print out here in the field code. So any variable that is available to the node is also available to Display Suite, and so you can print, you can put your custom formatters, your image, specific image cache setting, which actually in that case you wouldn't need to because it's included. But say you had a module that was not officially supported by Display Suite, recurring date or something like that, and you know how to do it in code. There's snippets out there. You can put them in here. That field is then available for you to drag around and drop around. One of those links, and I'll show you guys right here, as a matter of fact. Let's find it. I think I may have closed it down. But the developers at Display Suite on the Display Suite Drupal.org page have actually put a series of snippets for the most requested fields. Taking so long to load. All right, the other block I wanted to show you guys on Display Suite was add a new block field. This just allows you to drop any block that's available in the Drupal, any block in your system. You can create a field out of it, which kind of sounds confusing. But what it's saying is it allows you to have a block then that you can drop any block into one of those Display Suite regions. So for people who have used the Views Attach module, it kind of does the same thing, essentially, as that. It's really cool. I'll show you the fields I used here. The ND location map is a view. I only want it to show up on location. I want it rendered through the block template. So the other options, just the title and content, or just the content, which is going to print everything in that content variable. Big time saver when it comes to theming. Field groups is somewhat similar to CCK field groups. It's a little different in the sense that what it's doing is it's saying, hey, I want to group these fields together and use them as one kind of field that you can then drag around and drop into those regions. All right, so display suite's a little bit more straightforward. That's how you get it set up. Panels. When you install panels, you're going to get two items under site building. One is pages, one is panels. If you want to enable Node, the Node templates controlled by panels, you want to go to pages. I think I need to install Memcached on my Mac. This is long load times here. Drupal likes you to have cookies turned on. Any questions while this is loading? I may have to reset Safari here. I'm not sure what's quite going on. All right, so here's the UI and panels where you tell it what you want it to control. And you see we have, right now, the node template. What you're basically telling is that any time somebody hits a node, you want panels to control it. Well, it's not going to do anything until you tell it which nodes you want to control. And the way you do that is you create a variant. I have a variant set up here basically that says if somebody requests a node of content type event, I want panels to intervene and take over the layout, but no other time during the node when the node is requested. And you can also have it control the node edit form, the node add form, any system template in Drupal it can intercept, including user profiles. And then you can set additional context on that. For example, you can say if a user has a role of content editor, show them this page. If it, you know, with maybe some additional fields or notes or et cetera. If it's an anonymous user, I want them to see this version of the page, or if they're coming from this location, et cetera. It's incredibly powerful. What most people say about panels, if you're not used to it, just go through the UI. If you don't understand what it's asking you, just click through, and it'll generally work out of the box, and then you can kind of figure it out from there. And the documentation's getting a lot better as well. Any questions on the node template stuff? All right, I'll talk briefly about mini panels. What mini panels allows you to do is create blocks with panels. So you get the same benefits of panels. You create your blocks, and then you can then set those blocks just as you normally would, either with the context module or via the standard Drupal admin build block interface. The cool thing about blocks built in panels, besides having all the different abilities, is that they're kind of context aware. So once again, language, location, et cetera. All right, well that is essentially it for the panels and display suite overview. Are there any other demonstrations anyone wants to see or any questions on?
Yeah, the panel, using panels to control node edit forms, what elements of the node edit form does panels actually give you access to move around?
That's a great question. The question was, when you're using panels to override the node edit forms, what fields does it give you? This is a situation, if anyone has submitted a session for Drupal Camp Atlanta, I did attempt to control the node edit, node add form with panels for that, and it didn't work out because it was too general. So if you have any kind of, well here, I'll just, nothing like showing you. But that is one area where I'm finding I'm still having to just theme the old school style of tpl.php for the node edit forms. It's just not there yet. And actually in IRC, I asked Merlin at Chaos, the creator of the panels project and the views project, I specifically asked him that question. I said, hey, any chance of getting node edit forms being more granular so that I can grab each additional field? For example, you know, you may not want someone to see published a front page or input type, et cetera, and to hide those individually. Essentially, it's broken down into the general ones and then the different CCK ones. I apologize for this. I don't know why it's tell you what, I'm just going to reset Safari here. It usually happens during the live presentation, not when you're practicing. So, I think while I'm at it, I'll just reset my stack here. Doug?
Throwing an edit form into panels, is that kind of an alternate method of arrange fields? Is that the idea?
Yeah, and what the display suite guys, the way they handle this, the question was when the node edit, if I understand it right, during the node edit form, is it kind of the same as using some of the other methods out there of controlling it, like the node form calls? Is that what you're talking about?
The arrange fields model that you move all the fields around the layout until you know the layout.
Okay. What's the name of it? Arrange fields module. I think so. The one that I'm familiar with is called node form calls, and that's the one the display suite guys recommend. But that basically kind of gives you a left column and a right column, and I think maybe a header or footer, and you can arrange those forms. But what I have found is that if you want to completely exclude things, sometimes you have to exclude groups of things, unfortunately. Yeah, I think this was my problem here. Here we go.
Hey, Brent, who did the display suite module?
His Drupal.org username is Swentel, Swentel. I'm not sure.
Is there a company?
Yeah. I'm sorry. The question was who created the display suite module. They're in Europe, but I'm not sure the name of the company. I know they did a... I wasn't there, but I think DrupalCon San Francisco was kind of when they did the big unveiling of it. And it's project.ds. It's kind of a, but it should tell us. Anyone else having trouble with the Wi-Fi? Or is it just me? Coming and going? All right, could be it. I'm still trying to pull it up, Jared, but basically, you know, all the forms are grouped together that are the standard publishing options, input filter, all that are kind of grouped together. So you either have to show them all or you can't show any of them. So that's why.
And if you create your own fields, does it give you those individually?
Yes, it does. The question was, if you create your own fields in CCK, does it give you those in the form edit element? And yes, it does. It's like, you know, it's like one of those things where it's 80% there, but it's unusable because it's not 100% there. It's real close. And I don't understand exactly what, I know there are some architecture limits as to why that's difficult to do. I don't know why I'm not able to get to this.
General question.
Yeah.
Drupal 7 is coming out, but I'm looking at a lot of different modules, including this panel, so you can say, well, okay, I can start using this to develop, but do I get tied in with this kind of thing that the whole game changes on 7 and I got to relearn everything?
Right, so the question was, if I'm going to go with display suite or panels, then could that hinder my migration to Drupal 7? Yeah, it could. Right now, there's really no solid upgrade path from D6 to D7, and my understanding is that's what's kind of holding it in alpha. And a lot of it has to do with the fact that fields, which was CCK, are now in core, and there are different ways of handling things. And so Display Suite currently has a Drupal 7 alpha or beta that is working pretty stable. Panels, they had a sprint, I think 2 weeks ago, out on the West Coast in San Francisco to try to get it. But panels will be a part of 777 eventually.
Would it make sense to start coding in 7?
It just depends. That's personally, I'm not doing any D7 sites yet. The question was, does it make sense to start a site in D7 now? And that's kind of the million-dollar question right now. That just depends. I mean, there are live sites out in Drupal 7, but these are companies that have the ability to maintain core patches, roll things back, et cetera. So I would say not ready yet. Yeah, I'm still building everything in Drupal 6. If there's a project that's perfect for Drupal 7 that doesn't have to launch right away, then I might delay it. But those are all just personal projects. Obviously, if a client comes and they're ready to go, you got to make that decision. But it's, yeah, panels, is, you know, and views for that matter, I don't think are going to be ready right away. My take on the question was, what are the best situations to use panels? And other guys can pipe in. There's a lot of Drupal experience in the room. And I certainly don't have all the answers. But what I use panels for is if I have a complicated landing page that's going to have multiple views, multiple fields, I'm going to do that in panels almost every time. If I have a content type, a node type, that's going to have different fields, images, you know, whatever, I make a decision. Is this something I want to do with Display Suite or with panels? And once again, I almost always use panels, but what it really comes down to is arguments. Panels has much more robust ability to pass arguments to the view. And I can pull up a view as well, maybe. I can't seem to pull up much of anything. To show you that you can send a taxonomy term, taxonomy vocabulary, you could send it really anything that's available to the path will be available to the embedded view. It's not true with Display Suite.
So an online portfolio and
The question was, well, does panels kind of simplify a site build out? I think it does, but it's not mutually exclusive from CCK. You're still going to have to build your content types with CCK, and then panels just gives you an option of how to display those content types. All right, guys, I'm giving Firefox a try now. I'm at a loss. If I no, never mind. I'm myself in trouble. Yeah. Any other questions? Go ahead. Yeah, the question was, can you view source on the markup and see how see what was used? Yeah, usually, unless they took steps to intervene in that. Panels, well, you'll see pane and you'll see some other things. You can actually, there are pane.tpl.php files as well. You can kind of control that. Display Suite, I think so. Yeah, it's been a while since I looked at it. Currently, I'm only using Display Suite for one site, just a simple blog site. Everything else I use panels. Unless it's requested.
But. Can you use the node pane to override panels per content type, or is it all or nothing?
Okay, and the question was, can you use the node edit type per content type? Yes, the great thing about panels is you tell it, I want the node edit forms to be controlled by panels, and then it will do nothing until you go in and say, I want, then more granularly, I want you to create a variant where this node, if this content type is requested, and it's path node/edit with that content type, then it will take over the controller there. So, but like I said, it's like 80% there. Still not using that in production. Well, guys, I don't know what to say here. I'm kind of stymied on the internet. I can't even seem to get my local stuff to run. You guys mind if I reboot it? No. All right. Why not? And if anyone else has experience with panels or Display Suite, you know, their likes of the using context more than panels, et cetera, please feel free to chime in. There's a lot of experience in the room. Right. Yeah, sure, I could talk a little bit about that. The question was panels versus context versus Display Suite. And it's one of those things that a lot of smart people, you know, the beauty of open source, a lot of smart people saw the problem in the community, and they kind of all attacked it from different angles. One shop decided to kind of go with Display Suite in-house and released it. Panels is the brainchild of Earl Miles, who, you know, most of what he does, it takes me about 6 months to wrap my head around it, and I think it's the greatest thing since sliced bread once I finally figured it out. And then Context Module was also put out by the ability of people that were frustrated with the kind of the way that you had control block visibility and some other things in Drupal. People have different preferences, and I actually use them all kind of all together, which is probably not necessarily the best way to go. But DrupalCampAtlanta.com, for example, the sidebar is being laid out with the context module, as are the active menu items. So you kind of get a sense of where you are on the site. You can, but you can also make the question was, can you use them all together, or do they step on each other? If you know what they're doing and how they're doing it, you can use them all together, yes, but they can conflict. And there's multiple ways to do things. You know, for example, if you had a block that you wanted to be visible, one way to an authenticated user and another way to an anonymous user. For example, you guys all registered for Drupal Camp Atlanta, you saw a big orange register now button that sent you to the registration engine. If you were logged in, it just said you're attending and didn't go anywhere. There's a couple ways you can do that. With the, I did it with just PHP in the block. You could create a mini panel that was context aware and set it in the sidebar however you wanted, including with the context module. If panels control the entire page, which is an option I didn't mention, you don't have to have your different regions. You can say panels take the whole page minus the menus, the header, all that stuff, but it'll take the sidebar regions. And then you can set your blocks with panels as well, and then those blocks will be context aware. There's also context in panels, which is something different. It's confusing, but it's personal preference, and what I recommend doing is just kind of playing with them. If anyone saw the stuff from Context Module this morning, it's phenomenal. I don't ever go to the admin build block page ever, so. The question was which one to go with going forward. I will say this, that one thing of the Drupal community that definitely seems to be kind of a concurrence on is the use of features, the features module. And context is kind of out of the box working with all of that. So anything that, I'm starting to think of sites more in feature sets. And so when I'm trying to architect the site and say, okay, I want it to have this feature. If I think that a block, for example, a calendar, a mini calendar block, I want that to go with events. That makes sense. So that's something I'm going to set with the context module so that I can export it to my feature. So my personal opinion is that they're all going to be around. And they kind of all do different things. But I don't think you can go wrong, honestly. Yeah.
While you're wrapping up the reboot there, I want to point out that we've built awesome sites in Drupal before we had these fun toys. These fun toys rock. And they should be learned, but if you're trying to get your site off the ground, this will probably slow you down before it helps you. But if you can jump onto this and grab it and understand it quickly and utilize it and harness it, that's awesome. But above all, the future project will.
Yeah, these come in at the theming level. I wonder if a local will get redirected for this. Yeah, I think that was my issue, actually. I think I just didn't have my my Wi-Fi session expired. Well, now the local stuff is working. Okay. Do you even still want to see the node edit form, or have we moved beyond that? All right. Also, we're going to be putting the Drupal Camp Atlanta website code out somehow for you guys to pull it down locally and play with it and see how things are set up. Once again, I'm not claiming that it was done with best practices. It's my practices. but you can see how it was set up. Yeah. Here are those things that Jared was talking about that are the most neglected style elements in Drupal. You know, your tabs, login, stuff like that. If you guys didn't figure out, this site was not actually completely finished when we went to launch. Anything else?
You said panels being used for site building options, like there was pages, and then there was a panel. What would you give each one? Why are they separate?
Okay, the question was that, yeah, you get under site building, you have pages and panels. The reason it's like that is because pages, the page manager module, is actually part of cTools, Chaos Tools. And what they, when they were architecting panels, what they found, Earl Miles, what he found was, and correct me if this doesn't sound right, but basically he was, a lot of the stuff he needed to do in views and panels, exportables, other ways, it was reusable code. So he pulled that stuff out, created a separate module for it, and the page manager is part of that module. And then panels didn't realize it's more of kind of like the UI overlay that goes on top of that. The page manager, what the page manager options are it shows you all the system, themeable, temp, you know, node, user, all those things. And that's where you're going to go in there and set whether it's enabled or not, active or not. But there's links on both. You can kind of get there from both places. They will both prompt you to create a new panel. And what I showed today were two types of panels. A landing page where you just put a path in, like you would with a view, and you just drag and drop whatever you want into that panel. The other one, which was telling it, I want you to take over this content type every time that content type is viewed. So whenever my content editor creates a new content type of whatever X, it's going to have that same layout. Any other questions? We've got about 15 minutes or so. You guys want to see the interface for how you drag content into different regions?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
All right. I should have said predicated on whether I can get it to come up. All right, so what I'm going to demo here is the sponsors page, where I have five views embedded in the content area, and then I have the sidebar being set with the context module. So you can see, can you guys still hear me if I step back? These are my views, essentially, and your different options are, you can override the title, you can set the styles, it's all done through here. But if I wanted to add a new view, you just go to add content. I've just got one region, it's just a one column region. One thing to note, the new version of panels does not work with Skinner. There's a patch that's out there for that right now. So if you're planning on using Skinner, you might want to grab one of the older versions out of Drupal CVS. It has to do, I think, with the inline editor. Yeah, this is going swimmingly, that this won't load either. All right, here we go. So here's where you have your options. You have existing node or custom content, so you can grab a node by ID. You can, custom content is just essentially uses one of your input filters. You can choose full HTML, filter HTML, whatever you have set up in your input filters, it's going to be available there. Widgets are different site elements, the search form, different things. Your page elements, variables that are set through Drupal. Miscellaneous is where you're going to find all your views. So here you get any view that you want in the entire system, and you can say we wanted to put the tweets in that block. Click on that. It, in theory, this is really kind of crazy. All right, so now it's down here. We can grab them, move them around. You can see it's a lot easier when you're kind of in the planning phases of a site to use this as a build-out tool as well. It's kind of like super wireframing maybe, or you say, oh, that doesn't look exactly right there, let's move it around. You can save, you can change it back pretty easily. You have other settings. Disable Drupal blocks regions, that's what I was talking about. If I do that, and save it. We're now no longer going to have our sidebar over there. There's something called Panels Everywhere as well that's out, and so that will not only, if you turn that on, it doesn't just disable the sidebar, it disables the entire page. So you can drag the menu, the primary menus wherever you want, you can drag the site title, any of those Drupal variables. You can then move around the footer, footer message, et cetera. So, and I think there are some production sites that are full on using Panels Everywhere. And I heard in one of the Lullabot podcasts that, they're actually, when you use Panels Everywhere, it can actually be faster than, the PHP template system. So for those that are concerned about performance with Panels. Panels kind of has a reputation of, oh man, that's going to blow your site, it's going to slow down performance. And some people smarter than me did a bunch of benchmarking and said, no, it's not really the case at all. All right, if there are no other questions, I guess that's everything.